Where we sit right now in history is right at the cusp of a complete paradigm shift in how we think about mental wellness. If we had a problem that we perceived here, it seemed like it made sense that it was in the brain and we should target the brain. And that's what we've been doing for the last 100, 200 years. What we're realizing now is that maybe that isn't our primary target. And what we're seeing here in the brain is a secondary effect of something else that's happening in the body. And what we've just learned in the last 5 to 10 years is that yes, that is a secondary effect. The primary effect, and therefore the primary target, is in the gut. That's the second brain. That's where we have 100 trillion bacteria in our intestines. That number is more than there are stars in the galaxy, in the Milky Way. So the gut microbiome makes more serotonin than the brain does. That's the feel-good neurotransmitter. It makes more dopamine than the brain. In order for these neurotransmitters in the gut to have their effect in the brain, they have to be able to communicate with each other. And they do that through chemicals that the gut makes, chemicals that the bacteria make, that travel throughout the body, that signal through the nervous system, that signal through the immune system. This idea of the gut-brain axis, targeting the brain, but targeting the second brain in the gut, and then targeting the communication network between them, that axis, that's really the forefront of medicine these days, and the forefront of science, and the forefront of how we're gonna actually get ahead of all of these mental wellness issues and have a benefit in people's lives.